What happens when you get a billionaire CEO excited about going to Mars? Well, you get this. You get a really big rocket. That's what we're talking about today. Let's get to it. Elon Musk has always wanted to send people to Mars, but SpaceX has never had a definitive plan on how to accomplish that. That is, until October 2016, when Elon Musk outlined the architecture for the Interplanetary Transport System. The Interplanetary Transport System consists of three main components. The first is the spacecraft itself. The spacecraft is designed to carry 100 passengers on the trip to Mars. It also contains a cargo segment designed to carry cargo. The spacecraft also has its own propulsion system, intended to put itself into orbit, transfer out of orbit to Mars, and meant for the landing itself. Second is the tanker. The tanker is a modified version of the spacecraft with the cargo and passenger sections removed and replaced with more fuel tanks. I'll get into a bit more of what that is for later in the video. Lastly is the booster segment, referred to by Elon Musk as BFR, or Big Falcon Rocket, consisting of 42 Raptor engines in the first stage. The BFR produces 28.73 million pounds of thrust. That's almost four times the liftoff thrust of the Saturn V. That means the booster segment of the Interplanetary Transport System is the most powerful rocket ever. The whole mission begins with the launch of the spacecraft itself on top of the booster segment. After getting the spacecraft most of the way to orbit, the booster segment separates from the spacecraft, turns around, and returns back to the launch site, landing on the exact launch pad it lifted off from a few minutes prior. The spacecraft then uses its own propulsion system to place itself into a preliminary parking orbit. After the first stage is landed, it is fitted with a tanker and the whole stack is refueled. The whole launch process is repeated with the booster segment landing back at the launch pad. The tanker, a modified version of the spacecraft, will take itself into Earth orbit and eventually rendezvous and dock with the spacecraft to refuel it. Afterwards, the tanker will then turn around and return back to Earth, landing back at the launch site. The tanker does not carry enough fuel in one mission to fully refuel the spacecraft. In fact, it takes between 3 and 5 tanker missions to fully fuel the spacecraft for a mission to Mars. Once the spacecraft is fully fueled, it has to wait for the Mars transfer window, which only comes about every 18 months. When that time does come, the spacecraft will fire up its engines and head on a 90-day transfer to Mars. Once at the Red Planet, the spacecraft will enter the Martian atmosphere using aerobraking for its initial descent before turning retrograde, firing its engines, and performing a propulsive landing on the Red Planet. As you can probably imagine from the fact that this spacecraft carries 100 people, it's not exactly a small spacecraft. This spacecraft is actually larger than the space shuttle, meaning not only will it be the largest thing we've ever landed on Mars, it'll be the largest thing we have ever launched into space in a single launch. You may think this whole plan of launching, landing the rocket back on the launch pad, and relaunching and refueling and all this is completely crazy, and you're not wrong. But I'm not done yet. There's more. The entire interplanetary transport system is designed to use the new Raptor engine designed by SpaceX. And what makes the Raptor unique is it runs on methane. Why did SpaceX choose methane instead of the RP-1 that they've used for the Merlin engines? Quite simply, you can make methane on Mars. Meaning, you can refuel your spacecraft on Mars. That's right. SpaceX is planning to refuel their spacecraft on Mars using the Sabatier reaction to generate methane from the carbon dioxide atmosphere and the water found in the Martian soil. This means SpaceX can refuel their spacecraft and fly it back to Earth. That's right, the spacecraft that they're planning to land on Mars will then come back to Earth and be reused. The entire system, the booster, the tanker, and the spacecraft are all meant to be reused. That is an integral part of the entire system. Reuse is what makes this whole system work. The booster segment alone is designed to be reused 1,000 times. SpaceX has only reused a rocket once so far, so this is a big, big long shot, really. The thing is, this whole system is not designed for a few send people to Mars, do your thing, come back home type mission. No. This is designed to build colonies on Mars. This system was originally named the Mars Colonial Transporter, but they decided to rename it to Interplanetary Transport System because it can go further than Mars. They realized that if they place fuel depots throughout the rest of the solar system, they can go to any rocky body in the solar system. This spacecraft can land on Titan, Enceladus, Europa. It can go anywhere in our solar system. This is a versatile spacecraft that with enough fuel could go basically anywhere. Another aspect of this architecture is its time scale. SpaceX is planning to land people on Mars by 2024. NASA isn't planning to do that until the 2030s. If SpaceX can do this by 2024, they'll beat anyone else to Mars. They'll have done something as a private company that no country in the world has done. That's no small feat. SpaceX's plans are admittedly very ambitious, and honestly, a little bit crazy, if you ask me. But can we say anything different about the Apollo program? Saying, when we had 15 minutes of manned spaceflight experience, that we were going to land on the moon? That was ambitious. That was crazy. And we did it. So, I honestly think SpaceX can do this. They have proven that they can do something that people thought was crazy. People thought that landing a rocket propulsively on land and then reusing it, people thought that was crazy. And then SpaceX did it. Just to say, yes, we can, it works, and we're going to make a business out of doing this. SpaceX can get to Mars. I have no doubt that they will put people on Mars. The only question is, will they do it before NASA? And I think they definitely have the potential to do that. If SpaceX can successfully land people on Mars and build a colony on Mars, it'll open an entire new chapter in not just spaceflight history, but human history. Building a colony on another planet. That is a huge milestone. And SpaceX, a private entity, has the potential to do something that in the rest of human history has only been done by entire countries. That's building a colony. SpaceX has the potential to build a colony on another world. And that's history. As an aerospace engineer, or at least someone who is studying to become an aerospace engineer, I could one day help them to do this. I could be a part of this. But even if I don't play a role, I want to at least be there, be here in Florida when that mission takes flight. I want to see that mission lift off. I want to witness the beginning of a new era of human history. And I hope you guys will share that ambition, will join me in watching history. Because who doesn't want to be a part of history? So I want to thank you guys for watching this video. I really enjoyed making this one. This is something I've wanted to talk about for a while, but I wasn't quite sure what to say or how to say it. But I'm finally making this video. So thank you for watching. If you enjoyed it, make sure to like this video. I think more people need to know about this plan to go to Mars. So share this video with your friends if you think they'll enjoy it. Share it with them even if you don't think they'll enjoy it. People need to know that we are entering a new era in human history. So thank you for watching. If you want to see more videos like this, please subscribe to my channel. I really appreciate those who have subscribed already. And yeah, thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.